Hey guys, how's it going? It's your boy, Big High Alone. And I'm here today on Trap Tech TV to talk about that time of the year. No, not Christmas, thank God. I am here to talk about Valentine's Day, tax time, you know, ching ching. A lot of money being spent around that time of the year, and health is, we're gonna go with a little battle between the Apple Watch Series 8 and the Apple Watch Ultra, and see which one works best for you and your budget. Let's go. Hey guys, we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna go through these and we're gonna go through them real fast. Let's be quick. The main difference between the two is gonna be the screen. The screen size is what is the biggest difference. Now you've got $799 for the Apple Watch Ultra. You're looking at $499 for the GPS cellular model, and 45 millimeter goes for $529. The GPS only version of the Series 8 goes for $399. There is no GPS only version for the Apple Watch Ultra. It only comes in GPS plus cellular. Now, you're going to have the 49 millimeter case size, and you're gonna have the 45 millimeter case size on this one. This one has the edge-to-edge display where it has the curved edge, as you can see right here. Let's take a look. Now you see, if I even take it to the sides, let's see, you can see the numbers from the side. So the edge is curved glass. It does scratch easy, believe it or not. I had another one and it scratched extremely easy, and I was highly upset about that. It gets up to about 1,000 nits. The Apple Watch Ultra is gonna get up to 2,000 nits of brightness. Now that's nearly 27% brighter than the Apple Watch SE and the Series 6 and above. This one is nearly 20% brighter than those. It's identical, I believe, to the 7. And it's nearly identical in almost every single way. It is essentially a 7. With one or two few tweaks, you know, to kind of make up for it. But this is swim proof up to 50 meters. This one's 100 meters. All the blood oxygen app, ECGs, high low heart rate notifications, irregular rhythm notifications, cardio fitness notifications, the temperature sensors that comes with the cycle tracking and things like that are all identical. Where you get the difference is pretty much there's the 86 decibel siren. As far as all your compass, backtracks, your gyroscopes, your high G accelerometers, crash detection, fall detection, it works on both of these. So both of these are gonna have the same thing as far as that there. So there's not much difference. Now, the difference as far as the GPS is this has a precision dual frequency GPS in the Apple Watch Ultra. So the GPS is going to be far more accurate than the Series 8. So if you're looking for a far more accurate GPS, the Ultra would probably be the one to go with. The available connectivity, like I said, it does have international roaming on both. It supports the family setup, GPS and cellular on both. You can connect family members who don't even have an iPhone. Now, you're gonna get up to 18 hours with fast charge on the Series 8. You're gonna get 36 hours with fast charge. I've gotten nearly up to 3 days off of this before it went completely dead. The main difference is the always on retina display though. This one has the wayfinder face with features. It's got a live compass for night mode and low visibility conditions. And with the 2000 nits of brightness, it is able to be read in pure daylight. So in direct sunlight, you're able to read this. You can see it, you know, in direct sunlight in this, but you will have a harder time reading it, especially with the 49 millimeter versus the 45 millimeter. It is a difference, trust me. This one this year only came in aluminum and stainless steel. This is recycled material that Apple uses, and it features a thick front, crystal with a flat base, robust geometry, durability. It is crack resistant, and the Ion X front glass on aluminum models. The sapphire front crystals on the stainless steel models. They come in a midnight, starlight, I want to say silver, and and product bread. Now, this only comes in this. This is it. So you're gonna get your orange, like I said again over here, with a super loud speaker. The speaker is way louder. The speaker is smaller on the 8, of course. You don't even see it. It's more of a, if I can get it in there and you can see it, it's actually more of a, there you go. You can see it right there. That is the speaker. And there's a huge difference. With this button, it's mappable. That does not have this, of course, on this side with the speaker. So, but they kind of match up on this side. But on this side, you have this. I've mapped mine to turn on the flashlight. So if I'm outside, I want to be able to just, you know, hit this flashlight, boom, 2000 nits in your face, boy. I think those are the key things that are different. Health and wellness, everything's going to be the exact same. The blood oxygen app, ECG app, high low rate, you know, for the heart, sleep stages, cycle tracking, and all that stuff. It's all the same. The safety and emergency features, you have the siren on the Ultra, and you don't have the siren on this one. The noise monitoring and the backtrack is available on both of these, especially with 9.3. Now, the difference is the emergency SOS call for help and alert, emergency contacts, fall detection if you have taken a hard fall, and crash detection for help in the event of a severe car crash, not a bumper, fender bender. Now, it is engineered for more of a peace of mind when you're out in the wild, or you live a wild life, I'd say. It's a siren that can be heard up to 600 feet away. Emergency SOS to call for help and alert, emergency contacts, fall detection if you've taken a hard fall, crash detection for help in the event of a severe car crash. So those are the same. Cellular connectivity with GPS and cellular models are both of these right here. The cellular connectivity comes standard with this, and that is just the way it is. There is no GPS only model. Now this one uses L1 GPS. This one uses the newer precision dual frequency L1 and L5 GPS. Everything else is pretty much the same, except this one has the depth gauge and water temperature sensor and the dive computer app, and that's available in the App Store. And it also has dual speakers and a 3 mic array for beamforming. This has a second generation speaker and mic, which was the same on the 7. My thing is, would you go out and spend $799, or would you rather spend, you know, and that depends on if you need cellular too. So let's go back to that. If you need cellular, if you need anything else, I myself would go with cellular always. Cellular is always the winner. So if we go ahead and throw these on, they're fairly easy to throw on. Literally stop them on, boom, out of there. He's on. So, let's take a look. He's not that big. If you can look at my wrist, it's not big at all. Doesn't look big on me. Normal size. Now, if I put this guy on, let's get him next to him. We're going to take a look at this. This one has what's called a G clasp. Looks like the letter G. Take the G, and this is for the Apple Watch Ultra, but it, like I said, it fits as well. You take the G clasp, run it through there, and the hook on the G goes through so the watch doesn't come loose. And now, if we put them side by side, now side by side, they actually, because of the edge-to-edge display, they actually look similar. You can see the depth is totally different there if I line them up on my wrist correctly. You can see the thickness now. Where they are sitting at on my wrist is making a difference too. Keep that in mind. But if you look, there is a difference in the way they sit and the thickness. The curve, the flat display and the curved display. My honest suggestion would be the Apple Watch Ultra. Even though it's $799, if you buy the Apple Watch Series 8, like I bought the Series 6 2021. Next thing you know, the 7 was out. And I was like, what in the world? It was less than a year. It came out 10 months later. And so I felt slighted. Now I had a Series 6 before this. The Series 6 was a year old. It was at 83%. Maximum capacity is 100%. Apple will replace them if it's within warranty time and it drops below 85%. My suggestion again is the Ultra. The battery, like I said, on my Series 6 was going bad at $75 for a replacement, my honest suggestion would be to go ahead, make that splurge, get the Ultra, call it a day. The 8 has that smaller battery, and like I said, once those go, the watch is pretty much no good. You're on the charger probably twice a day. You can't use it for sleep tracking because it's got to be charged. But I would definitely say the Ultra, the 8, if you want to just be sly and, you know, cellular doesn't matter, you can go ahead and grab the $399 model. And, you know, it'll be cute. And if you want to wear it and it just connects to your phone and you just want to wear it for regular exercise, I would even say go get the Series 7 instead of the 8. Because the 7 and the 8 are almost the exact same. You actually still have the ability to type with the keyboard. And that is something else I did not show. If you're replying to a text, this is CBS text me. So if CBS texts me, I can say thanks. Space, even got an emoji. Look at that. And it was easily swiped, easily typed. So, I mean, it's that in tune. You saw how precise that was. It's even that precise on here, but it's way more on the Ultra. So, that's my decision, guys. This has been Hylom, and this is Trap Tech TV. I'm out of here. I'll be back with another video with a full review. I'll catch you guys later. Peace.